kelihatan nih. Wah, harus sedikit ke pinggir nih. Aduh, untung aja nggak nabrak. Wah, parah banget sih ini. Lampunya cuma satu, gelap, nggak kelihatan. Lihat tuh, masa perumahan besar kayak gini nggak ada penerangannya? Wah, parah sih. Kayaknya aku harus ngelakuin sesuatu deh. Apa ya yang bisa jadi solusi penerangan di Indonesia ini? Aha!
Beton glow in the dark. Mungkin ini jawaban yang dibutuhkan masyarakat Indonesia.
Hey, my name is Christopher Jose. Probably the biggest problem that our team found so far is insufficient amount of street lighting. As you know, in Indonesia, the government always use street lighting to light the street.
But you must know something. First, to install street light, there are high costs needed and not every area has an availability of electricity. Two, electric consumption in Indonesia is always increased from year to year.
And to support sustainable development goals, number 7, affordable and clean energy. We are bringing glow-in-the-dark concrete as our solution.
To create a glow-in-the-dark concrete, there are two stages that need to be done in the process. The first stage is making the phosphorus layer, and the second stage is making the concrete mixture. For disclaimers, our test method uses pavement formwork with a size of 20 by 10 by 10 centimeters. The stage of making phosphorus layer. The material that we need in this stage is 200 gram style grout, 20 milliliters water, 40 grams phosphorus powder, and 13.8% phosphorus content. The process of making the phosphorus layer. First, mix the white tile grout with phosphorus powder and stir them until the mixture is evenly distributed. Then, pour the water slowly while stirring. Once the dough starts to get sticky and difficult to mix, drop an SP of approximately 3 until 5 drops. The amount of SP depends on the mixing method and the quality of the tile grout we use. Once the mixture is ready, pour it directly into a concrete mold that is 2 until 3 cm thick, and the gap between applying the phosphorus layer and the mortar layer on top is 1 until 2 days. The stage of making mortar mixture. The material that we need in this stage is 600 gram cement, 200 milliliters water, 300 gram sand, and 3 drops of super plasticizer. Process of making the mortar mixture. First, mix the cement with sifted sand. The ratio of cement to sand is 1 to 2. After mixing them, add water and stir the mortar until it is evenly mixed. Water is poured slowly while continuing to stir the mortar mixture. After it is mixed, give super plasticizer 1 until 3 drops so that the texture of the concrete has good agility. If the mixture looks too runny and watery or the ridges collapse very quickly, that means too much water in there and we have to add more dry ingredients to solidify our mixture. Then, after everything is done without the mixture bleeding, pour the mortar mixture into the concrete paving mold and wait 28 days until it is completely dry and becomes solid.
To implement the glow-in-the-dark concrete method, we need to do some tests, which are the concrete compressive strength test, the wear and tear test, and also the light emission test. The concrete compressive strength test is a mechanical test measuring the maximum amount of compressive load the material can bear before fracturing. The test piece in this case is the glow-in-the-dark concrete in the form of roadblocks, which is compressed between the buttons of a compression testing machine by a gradually applied load. The wear and tear resistance test is to measure the durability of the glow-in-the-dark concrete over time. In a pin on this wear tester, the pin is loaded against a flat rotating displacement such that a circular wear path is described by the machine. Then, the sample is carefully cleaned and weighed to be compared to the control sample to describe the durability of the glow-in-the-dark concrete itself. Lastly, there is a light emission test where the glow-in-the-dark concrete is put inside a black colored box. The sample is lit with xenon lights for 10 hours, which is the effective hours of sunlight per day. Then, we observe how long the glow of the sample will last. The application of the glow-in-the-dark concrete can be seen in the picture where the luminescence material is installed on top of the site and with the roadblocks. In the night, the roadblocks will emit light which will light the side and middle parts of the wall.
In a nutshell, we hope that this innovation can reduce the electricity consumption and therefore preserve the environment.
Hi, I'm Agnes Clarabella and our PAP is 19001, and these are my friends.
Hi, my name is Karina Fiola and I'm PAP 11001. Saya Christopher Jose, NRP saya B111985.
And we're from Room PA1, Environmental Science of Civil Engineering Department, Petra Christian University. Thank you for watching our video and see you!